हेलो फ्रेंड्स, हाउ आर यू फ्रेंड्स? टुडे यू विल लर्न सम इम्पोर्टेंट सिस्टम ऑफ हिरुडिनेरिया ग्रेनुलोसा, दैट इज इंडियन कैटल लीच. तो टुडे यू आर गोइंग टू लर्न, यू विल स्टडी हियर नर्वस सिस्टम, सेंस ऑर्गन्स एंड रिप्रोडक्टिव सिस्टम ऑफ लीच. सो फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल, सब्सक्राइब माई चैनल. Let's go. The nervous system of Hirudinaria is typical annelidan type, and it is divided into three parts. First part is central nervous system, second part is peripheral nervous system, and third part is sympathetic nervous system. Central nervous system, it is found within the ventral hemocoelomic system. And it is further divided into an anterior nerve ring, a ventral nerve cord, and a terminal ganglionic mass. Second part of this nervous system is peripheral nervous system. It consists of paired nerves arising from ganglia of central nervous system. Optic nerve paired arises from brain and runs forward to supply the first pair of eyes, prostomium, and roof of buccal chamber. Four pairs of optic nerves arise laterally from subpharyngeal ganglionic mass and supply the second, third, fourth, and fifth pairs of eyes. Each ganglion of ventral nerve cord gives off two pair of nerves, the anterior laterals and posterior laterals. Here you can see this is the diagram of subpharyngeal ganglion. This is brain. This is sympathetic nerve ring. And this is the nervous system and their nerves. Now, anterior lateral supply the nephridium vesicle, vas deferens, muscles of body wall and receptors. Posterior laterals supply the viscera, dorsal body wall, receptors and testis sac. Terminal ganglionic mass give rise several nerves supplying the receptor organs and posterior sucker. Now, third part of nervous system in Hirudinaria is sympathetic nervous system or autonomic, also known as autonomic nervous system. It consists of an extensive nerve plexus lying beneath epidermis within muscles and on gut wall. It joins with certain cells on both sides of peripheryngeal connectives. On the other hand, with certain multipolar ganglion cells irregularly distributed over the entire plexus of gut wall. Now, sense organs of Hirudinaria, it is made up of modified epidermal cells, which are of four types. And these are, number one is free nerve endings. These are found all over the body between epidermal cells with their ganglion cells found below the epidermis. These are the actually chemoreceptors that detect chemical changes in the surrounding water. Second sense organ is annular receptor, and because these are found in the annuli, so each annulus contain 36 very minute annular receptors, 18 on dorsal side and 18 on ventral side. So there are 36 total in number, arranged in transverse row. So these are the actually tactile organ, that is tango receptors, that is sensitive to touch. Now, third sense organ is segmental receptors. These are small, whitish elliptical papillae borne upon the first annulus of each body segment, four pairs dorsally and three pairs ventrally. And each receptor consists of two types of cells. First is tactile cells or tango receptors. Second is light sensitive cells. They function both as tango receptors and photoreceptors. Now, eyes, these are five pairs, and they remain arranged as a semicircle of black spot along the dorsal margin of the anterior sucker. One pair in the first annulus of each of the first first five segments. Each eye is in the form of a cylinder or cup-like structure. Its wall made up of black pigmented tissue which encloses a large number of clear reflectile photoreceptor cells. Each cell has a small rounded nucleus embedded in a thin peripheral layer of cytoplasm surrounding a crescentic hyaline cell lens or optic organelle. Cornea forms outer free convex surface of eye. Eyes become smaller posteriorly so that the fifth pair is the smallest. Each eye receives light only from one direction that is differently directed. Probably they only enable the animal to distinguish light from darkness and to locate the direction of source of light. Now, reproductive system of Hirudinaria. They are hermaphrodite, that is, each individual contains a complete set of well-developed male and female reproductive organs, and cross-fertilization occurs. Now, male reproductive organ, it is made up of, it consists of certain organs, that is, testis sac. First is testis sac. These are 11 pairs, small spherical structure, one pair in each segment from 22 to 22nd segment, located ventrally. Each sac is constructed of portion of coelom. From the wall of testis sac, spermatogonia buds off and give rise to spermatozoa. Now, these you can see in the diagram that these are the testis sac, and they gave rise a small duct known as vas efferens, and vas efferens open in a vas deferens. There are two vas deferens, and you know, 11 pairs are vas efferens, vas efferentia. So vas efferentia arises from posterolateral border of testis sac and run outwards to join the common vas deferens of its side. Now third is vasa deferentia. Each vas deferens is a cylinder, longitudinal duct situated on ventral body wall, extending from 22nd segment to 11th segment. They remain enclosed within a tubular coelomic space. Now, fourth structure, fourth organ is epididymis. You can see here very well. This is a detailed diagram of reproductive system. This is epididymis, present in the 10th chamber, and each vas deferens swells to form a highly convoluted mass, that is epididymis or sperm vesicle. They store spermatozoa. Now, next part is ejaculatory duct or ductus ejaculatorius. These are short and narrow duct. These are paired. Here you can see in the diagram, these are ejaculatory duct. They rises from the interior and inner end of each epididymis, and finally they open in the atrium. So next part is atrium. Ejaculatory ducts of both sides join a median pyriform sac known as atrium, present in 9th to 10th segment, and opens outside by male genital pore. Atrium consists of two parts. Anterior part is a vase-like rod, prostate chamber, and posterior a neck-like narrow penis sac. Prostate chamber has thick muscular walls covered externally by many prostate glands, and penis sac, it is a highly muscular tube containing a filamentous coiled tubular penis. So this is the structure of atrium. Now, female reproductive organ, it includes ovisac. It is single pair, hollow globular coelomic sacs. These are present ventrally in 11th segment, one on either side of ventral nerve cord. Next part is ovaries. Each ovisac is filled with coelomic fluid in which floats a minute, delicate, coiled thread-like and nucleated ovary from which ova are budded off. And next is oviduct. Oviducts are, you know, these are short and cylinder tube, tubular part, and these structure run inwards and backward. Next is common oviduct. Right oviduct unites with the left one in 11th segment to form a single and median common oviduct. The point of their union is covered by a thick layer of unicellular albumin glands opening into the common oviduct. The posterior part of common oviduct free from albumin glands, and it is folded and leads behind to vagina. So here you can see this is the ovary, ovisac, and this albumin gland, and this opening of the female genital pore on the 11th segment. Now next is vagina. This it is a large and pear shaped muscular bag like structure in the 11th segment. It increases in size and also become internally folded during breeding season. It changes into a short duct and open through the female genital pore on the 11th segment. Anteriorly forms a small duct. Here you can see. And ova are budded off from the ovaries into their ovisac, and they pass into oviduct, then into common oviduct, where coated with albumin secreted from albumin glands. Now ova passes into vagina, where they are stored till fertilization occurs during population. Now next is the formation of cocoon, that is utica or ichthys. This is very important characteristic thing in Erudinaria. Actually, fertilization is internal in leech, and fertilized ova are discharged into a cocoon for further development. And cocoon is formed during April, May, and June. Secreted actually cocoon is secreted in the form of snow white frothy girdle by the clitellar glands around segments number 9, 10, and 11. So clitellar glands also secrete an albuminous fluid deposited with fertilized ova inside the cocoon. Now the cocoon is then passed over the head of each individual, and prostomial glands secrete the two polar plugs of cocoon. Complete formation takes about 6 hours. Laid in a moist place on exposure to air, it becomes hardened. This cocoon is 25 to 30 mm long and 12 to 15 mm in width. That is in this is the diameter of the cocoon, and it may contain 1 to 24 embryos. This is all about nervous system, sense organs, and reproductive system of Erudinaria. Subscribe, share, and like my channel, and press the bell icon to get all my videos. Thank you very much.